Sidney Powell, who's lost 4 cases at this point, is still out there. And she's teamed up with Lou Dobbs, the last great defender of the president, to try to work through their feelings. Here's a little bit of their most recent interaction.
I've uploaded a ton of it on our website at defendingtherepublic.org. And Twitter is even trying to destroy our new website, kraken-wood.com, where we're also trying to get the word out to the American people on what's been happening here and the truth and upload documents. Twitter took our account down the first night.
Let me make you an offer very straightforwardly. We will gladly put forward your evidence that supports your claim that this was a cyber Pearl Harbor. We have tremendous evidence already of fraud in this election. But I will be glad to put forward on this broadcast whatever evidence you have. And we'll be glad to do it immediately.
Awesome.
We'll work overnight. We will take up whatever air we're permitted beyond this broadcast. But we have to get to the bottom of this.
I've argued for a long time that Lou Dobbs is already taking up more than his fair share of air. But yeah, we'll gladly just give it to us. We don't even care. We'll do it instantly. We won't check it or anything. I know judges don't like it, but I'm good with it. It's fine. We'll put it out there. Francesca and Mark, Sidney Powell is the only person involved in all of this that was so crazy that they threw her off the team. But she's been on Lou Dobbs more after that. She's still every night.
This is a really important point, that the one place they found where they can make their case and they can do it without being held to the rigors of evidence is right-wing media. So you're right. Lou Dobbs, Laura Ingraham, Sean Hannity, and then the OANs and Newsmaxes of the world, they'll let them just be fire-breathing dragons without having to show any of the evidence of this stuff. So they can still make a pretty powerful case, because remember, a lot of people watch that stuff. So they are getting to a lot of Americans, but legally, they're not moving the ball at all, because of course, there is no evidence.
Yep.
There will be evidence on kraken_wood_0085 internet passcode .net. Like, Sidney Powell is just, thank you. Like, if Christmas is canceled, Sidney Powell is my present, because I love how crazy she looks. I love how she looks like she is the auntie who's gonna just pull your cheek like 12 inches from your face, and or like gonna do like a rendition of Beauty and the Beast, and she's the Beast, and she's going like just her vibe, her like wannabe Carol Baskin, soprano wife vibe is so good. And she's so ridiculous. And she's just like, oh, there will be evidence. Let me just go over here.
Yeah.
Am I still on camera? I'm sorry. I still don't have any evidence. Like,
well, she lost her Kraken. Now she's got was that a digital Pearl Harbor he said happened?
Cyber Pearl Harbor. Was she wearing fur? I couldn't quite tell, but it looked like
she was wearing fur.
Of course. So the disgusting, a full range of disgusting is being represented. So
no, it was fake. It was very Ivanka booted to TJ Maxx like fake fur.
Oh, if it was fake, if it's fake, then it's the only good thing she's doing. It's fake. Okay, all right.
There you go. It's actually made from her own hair. So it does seem like the farther we get into this, the crazier it becomes. You start to wonder, like, God, really, you're still going to stick with it? But the thing is, like, the appetite out there for this insanity is still there, and with fewer and fewer people providing it, as people drop off when they realize, you know, that Trump isn't gonna be president and all that, like, there's even more incentive to be the last remaining crazy. You can get all those people, all the Twitter followers, all the revenue. Maybe they can do your Patreon. And so that's what we get, this sort of thing. And look, there is potentially a cost to the insanity. A lot of people are worried that telling all these people that the elections don't count and they're totally rigged and everything is gonna lead to bad results for the Republicans in the runoff elections that are coming. Well, Lou Dobbs is a responsible guy. Let's see how he attempts to walk the razor's edge.
Sidney, I've got to tell you, I'm not even going to contemplate the next election. I'm not even contemplating the January 5th election in Georgia. The hell with that. If the people of Georgia are dumb enough after what they have gone through in the November 3rd election to then go toward January 5th in a runoff and think that changing nothing will change the outcome, then the people of Georgia aren't half as smart as I believe them to be. And I believe the patriots in Georgia should stop this nonsense now.
Oh, so he's just not interested in the runoffs at all. Well, I have to say, he is crazy, but he's also now my favorite personality on all of Fox and Fox Business. I want him to have all the hours. Just talk about how Georgia isn't important for the next couple of weeks.
Ronna McDaniels going like, it's still important. Please vote. Oh my God. Why are we gonna?
Of course, it's a rallying cry. You know, he's doing his rallying cry thing, and that's the way he rallies. You know, and he's feeling sort of, he's challenging Georgians to show up. And the one thing we do on the left is we kind of laugh at this because it does seem so laughable. What I don't know on the left, I don't know if we can see how effective it is. You know, we'll have to wait. So I'm always scared that, you know, to us it looks so absurd because it is absurd. But I always worry that in its absurdity, somehow it makes it through and can be effective.
Well, yeah, I mean, so in this particular case, though, what would be the effective outcome? Like the most consequential thing would be whether Donald Trump, you know, somehow remains on as president, elections be damned. That is still a possibility, but it seems pretty unlikely.
I was speaking to the Georgia runoff. I mean, I was speaking to rallying Georgians to get out the vote and elect Republicans. That's what I meant when I said, you know,
I get what you're saying. I think you could use frustration over what happened with Trump to do that. Maybe I missed something, but from what Lou Dobbs is saying right there, he seemed to be implying that it doesn't matter. I'm not worried about that. I'm not worried about 2024. I'm not even worried about the runoffs. I'm paying attention to the Sidney Powell Kraken Pearl Harbor thing. Mm.
I'm saying
that could inspire me.
I got what Mark was saying. I think it was much more of the people of Georgia, why would they vote when the presidential election was supposedly stolen? That's what I got from that they should focus. And that's what, I mean, Dobbs clearly knows that Trump watches his show. What is in it? What's the future for Dobbs? I don't know. I don't even know how he's still alive. But anyway, the point is like, he's clearly doing this and performing this for Trump in the same way that so many have been performing for Trump. And I do think it is going to suppress the vote in Georgia, although it's going to be a tough race. And considering that it's in January and our COVID cases are only going up, our COVID deaths are only going up, and that is going to suppress a certain amount of the vote for people who actually believe in science, which I'm guessing are going to lean more Democrat.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a great point, though, about this runoff occurring at a time when there's already a lot of sort of baked in voter suppression. You know, the weather, as you say, the COVID case count. It's going to be a tricky runoff under the best of circumstances.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.